Alright, okay, today I'm going to discuss liars. Now, in this particular, I don't know, I guess I'll try to make it a mathematical equation. I mean, there's no reason why it should not be a mathematical equation. Okay, you have the truth. And I put the truth here at 5,000, and then I have the one who keeps a lie on the person with the truth, and that's at the 5,000. So there's a 5,000 of each. So you have the one who's the hearsay, and you have the one who's the truth. One is 5,000, and the other's worth 5,000. Now, if you have, go back to this hearsay person, the hearsay person. Now, as many people as they can gather, call on the phone, communicate with, as possible. With each one of those, there's a chance to gain additional. So let's say with each one is an extra 1,000. So there's another 1,000 from that person, another 1,000. And the reason is we'll go back to job justification. Because you call that person at work. You justified they had a job, you justified they are earning a living. So because you've done that, you've made a tight-knit connection with the person of hearsay. So the person of hearsay and that person who is on the telephone getting that moment of work in their boss's eyes, in the eyes of whoever is their manager. So, they got an oomph, you know, they got an oomph in their work effort, bonus plan, whatever. So there's, now, that person who is running on hearsay is 5,000 plus the 1,000 because of that person they called. So now they call another person. So if we're talking networkers here, my gosh, this is just amazing what a bank account you can raise. You know what I'm saying? Just you know, in this mathematical equation of telling a lie and passing lies around. So we're dealing with another 1,000, another 1,000, and another 1,000. So these are all garnered. I'm trying to turn it into a mathematical equation. How it's given so much weight, and so at the very end, let's say we're at 10,000. So the truth was only worth 5,000. But as a lie, when it's swished around and turned into a networking process that involves people and jobs and careers, that it kicks it up to 10,000 easy. All right. So that is the weight of a lie, and that's why they're so hurtful, because then you have these additional. You have these additional. Let's say five other people. Or five other organizations, if it's a work effort, that are also against you. So the person who actually told the truth is there with their little measly 5,000 weight value. Okay, and my gosh, I didn't call anybody on the telephone, says that person. I didn't call any government organization on the telephone. I didn't bolster anybody's career. I didn't make sure that for sure, in the light of their, what do we call it, their boss's eyes, they're a valid worker that day because they picked up the telephone and talked. So no, I didn't do that, says the liar. I mean, it's not the liar. I didn't do that, says the one who's telling the truth. Now, the liar did all those things, all right? I know, it can be confusing. Yeah, it is a weighted value, just like that. So there you go. So that's how come liars get so much extra, what do we call it, extra weight. They get extra weight. It's because it becomes a work value job justification effort also towards others. Not like they're after money or anything. But literally, it is a job justification event. So yeah, so the one who told the truth, is it value zero? Because after all of that went on, yeah, they've just been denounced. So yeah, anyway. Swell. So yeah, it's just a mathematical equation, I guess, looking at that way. So if anybody like tells lies about you, it's easier to deal with. Because it's somebody's just gaining a larger fortune through other people, through using other people. And I guess our society allows for it. Right? Anyway. Yeah. Ooh, don't cry. Somebody lies right there in front of your face. Don't cry.